This is Kevin King with Pinehurst Websites, and this tutorial is going to be on creating a sub-collection and then creating a navigation menu. So in this example, we've got a collection called Goat's Milk Soap, and we're going to break this down into sub-collections and then create some navigation menus. So I've actually already made one for the men's collection that is a goat's milk soap for men. So I will also put that underneath goat milk soap. I'm going to have another menu that pops out, and we're going to have from the garden and men and several other collections. But I'm just going to create one right here to show how this collection is made. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into the goat's milk soap, and I've just searched it to bring up all the goat's milk soap in here, and I'm going to make a small collection based on tags. So this one is going to be from the garden, so anything that would be from the garden will go into this collection. So we'll go with lavender, for instance, would go in there. Let's see if we can find a few here. Cucumber could probably go in there. Eucalyptus, Fraser fir, jasmine, and lavender, and lemongrass, and lilac. So what I want to do is I want to give these a specific tag so that they can go into this collection. So I'm going to add tags. And tags are case sensitive, so make sure they're always the same. So I'm going to add these tags to these products. And now I'm going to go over to collections and create a collection. And when I go down to my conditions, I'm going to use that product tag is equal to from the garden. And I'm also going to add another tag because I just want goat milk soap. So I'm using that it has to meet all conditions. So I'm going to go product tag is also equal to goat's milk soap, which I've already tagged all of these items goat's milk soap. So they'll automatically bring these items into the collection. So these are all the items that I just tagged. So now I have a collection. I need to go to my navigation menu, which is going to be under this online store. We're going to go to products, or not to products, to online store, and then to navigation. And we're going to go over to create a new menu that is going to come up under the goat's milk soap on the main menu. So we need to name it exactly the same as it is on this main menu, which is goat's milk soap with an apostrophe. So we're just going to add a menu called Goat's Milk Soap, and we're going to put our items. And we're going to connect this. This name can be anything, but it has to connect to that exact collection, which is from the garden. We're going to add another menu item, which is going to be the items that are for the men. Which I've already made this collection. So now when I save that menu, it's going to bring up a new menu. When I reload the page, I should now see, so I haven't reloaded the page yet, but I have no pop-out. It just has goat's milk soap. But when I reload the page, that new navigation menu should be under shop, and I've got goat's milk soap from the garden for the man in your life, and I can continue to add more collections just by creating collections like we just did with tags, and then I can connect them to the navigation menu and just bring up those items. So that's how it's done, and you can find more tutorials at pinehurstwebsites.com. Thanks for tuning in.